Welcome back, my name is Muligan, and this is Cradle. Probably some people of you heard of this. It's a first-person adventure game, I think. Probably. By the way, so that you know, I'm recording in 30 FPS, and these are the settings I have, because I cannot reliably record at 30 FPS if I have textures at high. I always had these little stops, lags, you can call them. Whatever. So let's close this. There we go. So first person adventure game. So you can pick stuff up. You can throw it away. You can pick it. This is not. You can get some stuff like this. Nope. Come on. My lighter. Into your inventory. There you go. A little small inventory, but it is an inventory. And you see, get some chests has been shut for many years. Now, what do we have? Bam! I do have played the first thing, or seen the first thing that I have to do. And yeah, the story, there's not much known right now about the story. We can activate our, I don't know, bride? Hello. Hello. Okay. And there she goes. Don't really know what to do there. The only thing... what do we have here? The on button is jammed. I can't press it. Interesting. We can jump, we can sprint, we can crouch. There we go. We can take this with us. We have some information. There we go. A button. Now the thing that more or less leads you at the beginning is this here. We have to do some cooking. We need to heat the red pot. So we need to get the red pot. If I could remember where everything was. Doesn't seem like a red pot. Close. Door jammed, fantastic. Where was the red pot? Don't think so. Red pot, we have a kettle, we have some stuff. We have this thing, which is not really a red pot. Let's see. Heat the red pot, add a glass of water, add a few cut plum olive fruits. There are plenty of them by the lake. Add right root, but don't forget to grind it. Add salt and the water will turn orange. Cook until it's done. So, first thing, let's simply go get the fruit. Let's go. So, it's an open world game, as you see. Mostly open world. Pretty nice to look at. I mean, I have turned down the graphics by half, if you can believe the settings. So this game would probably look a lot better if you can run it that way. And there are probably a lot of people. These red fruit, these are the ones that I need. I need to knock them down. I had. There we go. Now. Oh, wrong button. Left click to pick up, right click to throw. There we go, we got our fruit. Oh no. First pick up, then press E. There we go. Come on. And another fruit. Bam. There we go. So two should be enough. hopefully. I'm pretty interested in what is after this. You see these little power lines, they have these circuits in them. I'm pretty interested what these are. Could be some sort of transportation method. You see there. And you see behind the house is some sort of big dome, probably some settlement. But nonetheless, we got the fruit. We need to get some dried. There we go, root. We need to grind that. Let's pick it up, put it away. Still needs a red pot. Don't know where to find that. Nergoy Oxygen TV set. Model XG6000, elastic screen with ozone filler. Integrated motion suppression system. All broadcast formats supported. Okay, flags. Still needs the. Oh, wait. This is the red pot. Ha! Put it here. This is where we can. We are going to heat the stuff. Let's put some fire stuff in it. Some wood. There we go. Put all the wood in it. Come on. Mortar and pestle must be somewhere in the truckery. Put that. Now we have a lighter. There we go. Now we have something to boil. There, this seems like a mortar, a pestle, whatever, and this seems like a mortar. Let's see, can we put the root in it? We can. We then take this and there we go. This we can simply add. Done. Now we need some water. Can't seem to use it. What was it? There we go. There we go, some water. If you look at it, we got the red pot heating, glass of water. We need some, a few cut of our fruits. We got the root and then salt. So we need the fruit and then some salt. Salt. So put the fruit down. Nope. Whatever. Then, come on. It's bubbling. Okay. I need some sort of. Oh, definitely taking this. I need some knife. Knife, knife, knife. Maybe in one of the cupboards. Dusty bottles. We got some spoons. There we go. Knife. Two-headed turnip. Oh, right. There we go. No, 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 no. Wrong! Wrong! All sorts of wrong. We take the knife. We do this. We do this. There we go. And last but not least, come on. There we go. Put this all in here. All of these little cuts. There we go. And some salt. Is this salt? New task. Let's try. Nope, not salt. If you remember correctly, it turns orange. Yeah, it will turn orange if we add salt. So let's try. This is a yellow. Don't need yellow, need orange. Nope, this is red. There we go. This looks good. Looks orange. Ginger, garlic, Sichuan pepper. The pack is empty. Okay. So a lot cash voucher, cheese milk oats, sesame oil, pine nuts. Are we done? We are done. Now, we go out here. And there he comes. This is our little friend Ontluff, I think. And we can put his food here. There you go. He looks a lot better in higher graphics. I mean, he looks better, simply. Better graphics. Looking better, simply as that. Come on. Come, put, put. Our little friend. I don't know how. I don't know why. This is as far as I played. There he goes. Majestic. He looks really good. And there he goes. And now he can nom nom what we made for him. A little bit of salt, some fruit. Okay. Let's check again because of the name. The name was Ongots. Game is saved. So he's Ongots. New task added. He needs his vest changed. Now with tab I can see tips. Ziggy cannot speak but may still be of use to you. Change him. Replace Ongots vest. Okay. Let's try. Okay, okay. Okay. Go away. Interesting. Now I need a new vest. Where do I get a new vest? Can I take yours? Don't think so. Is this a new vest? Doesn't seem like it. Do I have a vest lying around? I could take this. Let's check. Let's see. Nope. Now the item doesn't work. It is probably out here somewhere. I would think. We have a shirt with a hole in it. Okay. Let's check, a new vest. Where do I find a new vest? Nowhere here. Here's the one before. Yeah, I'm searching. Oh, there we go, a new vest. Looks like the old one. Can't seem to use, what? Looks exactly like this one. No? Good. Then let's look around. Oh, wait. I think I have to put something in him. Like this? No, can't use. Do we have something else? Nope. Do you have something? Let's see. This? Maybe this we need? Nope. I think we need to put something in him. Do we have something? Wait, can I put something in you? Yes. Okay. Let's fix you up. There we go. What is this? Let's see. Can I check you with that? Ready. Let's take it with us. I still need a freaking vest. This is not the vest. Yeah. Not sure. Closed. What is this? Is this the vest? I don't think. Let's check. Can't take it? I have no need for this. Can I put this on her? Nope. Is there something? No. Stuff, so much text to read. I only want to... Where's your head? There. There, your headpiece. This should be the right thing, right? Can't use it. I can put it in my backpack, so it is something useful. Do I have to do something? Do I have to put something in you? But what? Can't use that. There's some sort of screen. Can't open that. What do we have? Some tobacco. Incense sticks, candles. I have no idea. Shut up. I can put that out. Get some more background story. New life manual. Okay. I don't. No. Is there some other rest? Have some bread or stuff? There's nothing here. Nothing that would help. Lid open. Close lid. No flower in the phytocopia. What is this? I have no need for this. Huh. Do I not? Where's the stupid vest? Can I put this back on here? Take all. I can't. Maybe I simply clicked wrong. Oh my freaking god! I clicked wrong. Bye bye. I hate you so much right now. I had the right thing the whole time. The vest has some numbers on it. Yes, it has. 2053. So I need something to use numbers on, like this. Nope. 2, 0, 5, and 3. I can't really use you for anything. You are useless. What is this? Read entries? Yes. 2, 0, 5, and 3. Access granted, okay. I've got a journal now, thanks Tabaha. My name is Anubish. I've always lived here because I can't go anywhere else. Grandpa Betjin says lots of people used to live around here, but they all died when the dome blew up, and the area has been deserted ever since. Aside from myself, Betjin and Ongots. Ongots has got very powerful claws. He obeyed my father and helped him hunt hares. I don't remember my parents, they died in the explosion as well. When the wind picks up, it gets pretty chilly. You can find refuge from it, but not for long. You can't last long without light. That's why I crafted this transparent layered vest, like in that program about greenhouses. It keeps Ongots warm during the day, and when the night chill arrives, I put him into another warm vest. I collect and digitize flowers. I look for the prettiest ones and make photocopies of them. Tabaha then takes them into town and sells them. The earnings keep him afloat while Grandpa and I buy cheese. We've got new A new genometer, it measures everything. Flowers, insects, people. It clocked Badgina at 47. And the tree by the gate at 24. Even the stool got measured. So that took a little longer. But when aimed at Ongots or myself, it still shows the same old error. Grandpa says it's all providence. Maybe he's right. I have this dream, sometimes I'm in a strange city. The day is waning, folks are walking in the distance. There's somebody beside me, but I don't see who. The dream is fleeting, always leaving me with a strange sensation. Like I'm supposed to pass something to somebody, but I can never remember what or to whom. I feel some kind of mix of anxiety and chagrin. And it makes me want to go there, to that town. Grandpa Badgin has died. He wanted to do a transfer after losing his sight and mobility. The Baha even brought him the equipment, but Grandpa died in his sleep. He was buried at the spot he had requested. Tomorrow makes the 4-year anniversary of Grandpa's funeral, which means I am already 23. Everything is still the same. I tried leaving again, but no dice. I simply lose consciousness like before. I want to find that town from my dreams. Perhaps I will risk it and do a transfer. Grandpa has got no use for his helmet these days, but I might. If I get lucky, I will wake up in a new body in Ulaanbaatar. Too bad the genometer won't show my number. I know how dangerous it is. When I look up at the poster over my bed, for some reason, I remember my toys. When I was a kid, maybe 5 or so, I had a favorite toy. An odd little space case. Ongots had found it somewhere and brought it to me. Then I saw dark swirls in the field, got scared and stashed the toys away for some reason. And to make sure I didn't forget the hiding place, I came up with a clue. Come out of your yard and fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will mystery betray. But now I can't find it. Okay, so we got a clue. Interesting. So, we learned some new stuff. This thing is the generator, I think. Let me try to find my cache. Perhaps all things will provide a clue as to what happened to me. Okay. Now, Ongot, we know, is some sort of cyborg. I don't know what my grandpa was. It seems he could transfer to a new body. So I think he was a cyborg too. Maybe he was not a cyborg, he was a normal human, and human could transfer their memories and stuff. I don't really know. Oh, what do we have here? Whereas the previous problem was solved with the help of slanting stitches, basting and taking thread is best for working with fate. The recipient is unconscious, his bodily movements are compulsory, and a mirror reflect of the donors. In essence, at this phase of the procedure, the donor controls both bodies. The recipient powers on the moment of two palms touch, but does not yet have access to his motor functions. By pressing his right palm to the recipient's left palm and looking himself in the eye, the donor initiates the transmission of memory. As was already mentioned, the mirror effect is critical for a successful transfer. Therefore, do not disregard our advice and install a quality look screen on your future face. Okay. Interesting. Some transfer information. So, I would think that we are going to try to transfer into her. I put some stuff in you. Are you more lively now? Oh, all these things have number. She has 93, this flower has 33, this flower is 26. And I would think, at least, that if my number is the same as hers, I can transfer into her. So she had 93, it was. Let's see if I... There we go. If I remove stuff... Come on. Put you back here. If I remove that... Okay. If I simply remove that and... Put her on. Okay, she's not able to function without. How about now? She is functioning. And she still has 93 as number. So the more stuff I put in her, the higher the number probably gets. Or maybe it simply changes. And I have to probably find my number and then get the number in her, the same as me, and then transfer. So I can leave. Now, she talked about this town. The person we are playing, I think, is she. So I will try to get closer to the town so that we can check out what really happened. What do we have here? Mongolian Post. Epistolary Communication Terminal number 905. Date of last cartridge load, July 1, 2058. Okay. Oh. Here you will find the answer to your question. Which question is that? We don't have any question. Okay. Now you maybe saw that if you wind back to as we run up here. I had some hiccups. I don't know if the game is loading stuff or what, but it happens most of the time. Now these things are interesting. They have a warning sign for max speed, so this is some sort of transportation device. In what way though is totally unbeknownst to me. Can't go up there. So let's check if we can go into the town or the thing. Normally the game said we cannot. There are some danger signs. Interesting. Let's check them out. They have little balloons looking around. Paratoxin contaminated. Keep away. Okay, danger area contaminated. Area. Okay, then this is not the town? Maybe this is the dome that exploded? She wrote in her diary. What do we have here? Are these... Can't really take these flowers with me. Okay, seems like a little map. What about this flower? Can't take that. So they shut off this area completely. Okay. So... I cannot go in there right now, it seems. And it is not the town, because we are still conscious. There's probably a town somewhere which we cannot get close to. Which means we have to find the cache, whatever. And then we will see from there. So, I will wrap up this episode here. Next episode, I will be at the house again, and we will go from there. We have a little clue where to find the cache. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, and comment. And as always, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.